Hey, Shauna.
A body, some would say, is a shelter, a place for the soul to seek refuge. Some would even call it a home or just a pile of dead skin and bones. But me, I'd say that this is my shell, my beautiful black shell. And like a crab, there's more to me than my shell, but my enclosure makes me unique. I came into this world, a spirit encased in new, soft, delicate skin, and was placed into the arms of a woman whose skin is much more fair than my own. She carried me as if I were glass, with extreme caution, care, and love. And she fed me the best foods to make me big and tall, except I'm 5'4", and doing stretches every day so I can be 5'7", by the time I'm 21. And she bathed me with the best soaps to preserve my new brown coat. She always told me how beautiful my shell was, but was the first to love me for what was underneath. A soul, a person, a child, one much stranger than the one she had created 10 years before. I hadn't really noticed my environment until I was much older. They called me Negrita in elementary school, but I didn't mind because I didn't know what it meant. But then in middle school, pardon my French, they called me that fat black bitch. That I didn't mind. I couldn't understand why they didn't like me for, they couldn't see past my shell. I thought I was liked and had approval from most, but no. My casing had halted those affections from soothing my pleading being. So I spent the next few years remodeling, trying to make my shell more suitable, more appealing for everyone. You know, not such an eyesore. So I scrubbed and I scraped at the top layer of my brown paint because all of the famous and popular shells that I admired and aspired to look like didn't share a similar pigmentation with me. Hours of tears, years of remodeling, endless horrific nights that kept my mind up because my shell wasn't pretty. The next few years, they were tough.
Come on, baby.
It's okay.
The next few years, I spent remodeling, trying to find the right me. I had to go to a lot of different stores, find a lot of different. No, I'm so sorry.
Don't worry, baby.
You got it, Shauna.
Deafening octaves had tried so hard to crack my spirit, and they succeeded. One crack led to another, and next thing you know, I had a big gaping hole over where my heart should have been. In a desperate attempt to save my soul, I used everything to piece myself back together. Plaster, putty, string, tape, even gum. And nothing could hold the weight of my tired, joyless being. Until one day, I found my glue. But this wasn't just any glue. This glue was indestructible. Once you used this glue, it was the fix. No more tears, no more pain, no more explaining to your friends why you were scratched and bruised from self-infliction. No, you were okay. This glue had a name. This glue was called acceptance. This glue was called confidence. This glue was called self-love. And I'm not gonna lie, it did take me a while to find this glue. I had to go to a lot of different stores and deal with a lot of not so nice employees. But I found my store and I found my people. And those people, they aren't just anybody. It's my family, the one I was born into and the one I got to choose. It's my mom, my dad, my sister, my brother, my cousins, my aunts, my uncles, my tios, and my tias, because there is a difference. My friends, my teammates, my coaches, they showed me what they had been seeing all along. They showed me how freaking awesome I am. And because of them, I now know that I, Shauna Lene Marsh, am beautiful inside and out, colored exterior and all. Thank you.